Let's talk about the nature of the electric field. If you have a single charge, like this one, sitting out in free space, we can assume that there is an imaginary negative charge someplace far away. What would the electric field line look like in that case? It would go from the positive charge to the negative charge. Electric fields always start and end at charges. They are open field lines. This is an open field line. That's an electric field line. We're going to study magnetic field lines, which are closed field lines. So electric field lines are open field lines. They always start and end at charges, and they always have a very distinctive pattern. In the case of this electric field that's out in free space, we could equally have had negative charges over here, far away, or over there, far away, or up here, far away, or over here, far away, or over here, or here, or here. The electric field lines around a positive charge, single positive charge, are going to look like the spokes of a wheel. One of the things that's going to be interesting is that the electric field, let's consider the electric field in this region right here, the electric field is associated with the density of the lines. See how close together the lines are in this region that's very close to the positive charge, and see how the electric field or the line density is much smaller out here on the outside. The electric field is proportional to the density of the field lines. Now let's go to another question. What would happen if we had a charge Q1 here, and another charge Q2 over here, and a third charge Q3 right there? And we want to know the electric field right here in the middle someplace. Well, we would have put a 1 coulomb test charge right there, and we could calculate the electric field that's caused by this charge, and by this charge, and by this charge, and they would all add up. So the electric field at that point would have been Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught over R, let's call this R2 squared in the direction R2, and it would have been, I should have put this one first, Q1 over 4 pi epsilon naught R1 squared in the direction R1. Add those two up, and then let's add in a third, plus Q3 over 4 pi epsilon naught R3 squared in the direction R3. We call this superposition, and what it just means is that this is the sum, I equals 1 to however many charges we have, of Qi divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Ri squared in the direction Ri. It means that we're adding up a bunch of vectors. You can see right here, for instance, that these two vectors are going to partially cancel each other out. And that's because we have an equal, similar force in this direction and this direction. They're both pushing. The charge isn't going to move. It will have no net force. This is the principle of superposition.